There are eunuchs who were born thus from their mother's womb, and there are eunuchs who were made eunuchs by men, and there are eunuchs who have made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven's sake. He who is able to accept it, let him accept it. Matthew 19:12. I wish that all men were even as I myself. Do we have no right to take along a believing wife, as do also the other apostles, the brothers of the Lord, and Cephas? 1 Corinthians 7:7-9:5. Eunuchs in God's Word. 5. While Scripture does not specifically point out any eunuchs born as eunuchs, medical textbooks speak of this kind of anomaly to normal births. Eunuchs made eunuchs by men are the eunuchs in some translations termed chamberlains we ordinarily encounter in God's Word. There have been many of these throughout history. Today we will address the third category of eunuchs the Lord mentions in the above verse in Matthew. Zealous men have in ignorance physically mutilated their bodies, but this is not the way to make oneself a eunuch for sake of the kingdom of heaven. The Apostle Paul is perhaps the outstanding example of what the Lord was here referring to. Nowhere does Scripture say or even hint that Paul had a wife. Some have conjectured that Paul was a widower. This too is without any biblical backing. The so-called church fathers likewise do not dispute that Paul was unmarried, a man wholly dedicated and devoted to the service of his Lord. Reading Paul's life and suffering in Acts and the epistles, we are astounded. We thank God for a man like this apostle who endured hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ and in godly purity abstained from the joys of marriage and having a family. Others too, male and female, Jan Darby for example, have lived pure, single lives to serve the Lord without distraction. 1 Corinthians 7:25-40 teaches us about this. It is still possible. Eugene P. Feder, Jr.